More Easter eggs, you say? Well, we've got you covered. Doctor Who Redacted Episodes 3 and 4 out and about, meaning we've rounded everything up for you. Let's go. Welcome to Tardis Central. I'm your host Jack, and let's get right into it. Another two episodes of Doctor Who Redacted, the BBC Sounds-produced radio play podcast series continues, with more references to other episodes of Doctor Who and the wider Whoniverse. So let's get stuck into both Lost and Angels. Like always, if you do want to keep up to date on all the latest Doctor Who news, lore and more, then make sure to hit that subscribe button to never miss a video from the team here at Tardis Central. You can also follow us on social media for daily updates on the Doctor Who universe. As always, please let us know your thoughts in the comment section below, because if we are talking about Doctor Who, then of course we want to hear about it. So kicking us off in episode 3, Lost, the thread on disappearances continues, as this time it's clarified by Shauna that Yaz's mum, Sonia, went missing. And now, so is Sonia's mum. Sonia's mum of course being Umbreon Khan, who was featured in Demons of the Punjab, both in present and in 1947. As this episode focuses on Umbreon's life and her fleeing from a partition, whilst the Doctor and company passively were involved, it seems that the Doctor's involvement then in events has caused the Redaction to take almost all of Yaz's family. And Cleo also discovers that Harish and Jeeta Chandra have disappeared too. Harish and Jeeta were Rani's parents and appeared in the Sarah Jane adventures alongside her, though both occasionally got caught up in the aliens' invasions and other strange events of the show without quite realising. They always got out safe at the end of the day. In Redacted, however, it seems no one's family is safe and they've also been taken. Another mysterious consequence of the Doctor's impact upon history being Redacted is that Cleo's workplace, the Queen Victoria Theatre, is now named the Lost Queen Theatre, due to the Great English Succession Crisis. She went into hiding because so many people wanted her dead. It is not entirely stated what the point of a historical divergence is, but it presumably has to do with Series 2 episodes, Tooth and Claw, in which the 10th Doctor and Rose meet Queen Victoria. One of my personal favourites, might I say. During the course of the episode events, they were saved from a plot by a long-standing brotherhood of monks, trying to implant with Queen Victoria with the genetics of an alien being they worshipped. The creature being, effectively a lycanthrope, had taken on the body of a young man from a local area. No more than an adult was used by the creature, as it turned into a werewolf and furiously hunted for her. It's likely that without the Doctor being there, the creature was able to successfully implant its genetics into Queen Victoria, only for her reign to be disrupted by other changed historical events, leaving the creature's plan to begin an empire of the wolf unsuccessful. When discussing the disappearances, Shauna mentions several occurrences. Giant spiders in Sheffield, yetis in London, radioactive maggots in Welsh mines, these incidents were events in previous stories. Firstly, the series 11 story Anachrids in the UK. Secondly, the season 5 story, The Web of Fear, in which the second Doctor came face to face with a robotic yeti and a controller, the Great Intelligence, within the London Underground and the surrounding area alongside a companion, Jamie McCrimmon and Victoria Westerfield. That's a mouthful. Now lastly, the season 10 story, The Great Death, features the third Doctor and Joe Grant take on a malicious corporation, Global Chemicals, whose profit-making and efficiency-based focus on environmentally unfriendly chemical processes. This had begun to mutate the nearby creatures within a local mine, specifically the maggots, hence radioactive maggots. In addition to these, there's also a mention of a friend of Ryan Sinclair called Tanya, searching from him on Twitter. Why you'd search on Twitter, I have no idea. Though not definite, this may in fact be a cheeky reference to Tanya Adeli from a spin-off, Class, and suggests that she's become friends with Ryan since her time at Coal Hill Academy. However, we'll have to wait and see if this one turns out to be anything definite for now. Now moving on to episode 4, Angels, our first reference comes out when Abby tells aside Cleo and Shauna a ghost story. The story, about a house called Wester Drumlins, is in fact a reference to the series 3 episode, Blink, in which a woman called Sally Sparrow finds herself caught in the schemes of mysterious and malicious weeping angels, after they've already dealt with a 10th Doctor and Martha. You know, honestly, Blink was one of the freakiest episodes when I was growing up. It still gets me to this day. Now with them, both vanish into the 1960s by an angel's touch. Sally and her brother's friend, Larry Nightingale, had to save the day. The story had also suggested that many had fallen victim to the angels within the house. And indeed, recently the video game, The Lonely Assassins, picked up on this again. With Sally having moved away to America, it was up to Larry and Rani Tandra, under a pseudonym, to investigate unusual occurrences, including the disappearance of Larry's wife. With Rani sidelined, and Larry eventually whisked into the past by angels, the angels were defeated by Petronella Osgood, an unidentified individual controlled by the game's player. As the game established, Larry had actually spent time warning people away from buying Wester drumlins, and about the dangers of the angels before the disappearance of his wife, even making mention of it online. So it seems these warnings had spread out onto the wider world. Reference is also made by Abby to Larry's blog, Into the Unknown, which is also a key part of the game and features several stories about potential connections to the Doctor. However, as the story progresses onwards, it establishes that Larry Nightingale has remained in the past. The Lonely Assassin concluded with a series of epilogue for players who fulfilled certain criteria during a playthrough, with the 13th Doctor reunited Larry and his wife in the past timeline. The game had left it uncertain if they'd stayed in the past or both returned to the present day once reunited, but it seems now we have a definitive answer to that, as here, Larry has left a tape for the trio, hidden under the Glasgow necropolis. Another potential, but subtly jokey reference may also be to the present in Cleo's quip to the other statues can wipe memories if you fall on your head, as this does indeed happen in Series 4, The Unicorn and the Wasp, with the story's twisting turn and murder mystery. Miss Chodaka has a sudden moment when she realises that Professor Peach may have been murdered from looking into Lady Edison's family. Unbeknownst to everyone, but Chandrika and the woman herself was a second Edison child born out of a relationship with Lady Edison, but with a vapid form in disguise under the name Christopher. When Chodakala, that's a complicated name, I am not going to bother pronouncing it. When she'd rushed off to speak with Lady Edison about this, the second Edison child, also a Vespa form, had realised the danger she posed and quickly dealt with her by dropping a statue on her head, literally destroying the only memory of them besides that of Lady Edison. We shouldn't say much more, as in the spirit of a murder mystery, it's better to find out the events for yourself. But ouch, what a potentially cool joke. Nearly at the halfway point, Redacted certainly has shaped up to be a lovely series and quite fun to spot with references in. Did you know all of these? Whether any of us surprised you? Or do you think we're perhaps missing something? We'd love to hear your thoughts in the comment section below. If you do want to keep up to date on all the latest Doctor Who news, lore and more, then make sure to hit that subscribe button to never miss a video from the team here at Tardis Central. You can of course follow us on social media or join our community Discord server. For now, I've been Captain Jack, thanks for watching, and if a redaction hasn't rewritten history, then hopefully we'll see you next time.